covenant of love. You love one another and your decision to move to the next step in this relationship is honorable in the sight of the Lord. And may He forever knit your hearts together with His blessing, His favor, His grace, and His infinite wisdom. Marriage was first ordained by God in the Garden of Eden when He decided it was not good for one to be alone. And He granted the first man Adam a wife who was named Eve. And they were to be an example for all other unions to be made thereafter. And what the Lord had said concerning their union, which also applies to your own, is that when a man joins unto his wife, they're no longer two, but they have become one. Now, this is the kind of unity that binds your very souls together. And the Lord has skillfully crafted this design that when one is rejoicing, the other is also partaker of the other's rejoicing. And when one is burdened, of course, the other is also partaker of the other's burdens. Your decision to be a creation declaration and your promise to one another that you will with sincerity be together in sickness and in health, for better or for worse, for richer or for poor until death do you part. It is a chance of what you gave a destiny. And love, I believe, is not the only thing that the Lord has granted in this day, but also His blessing. At this time, I would like to share a passage from Scripture concerning love. The Bible tells us in the book of 1 Corinthians 13, it says that love is kind, love is patient, love does not envy, it does not brag, does not boast. Love does not behave itself unseemly. It's not easily provoked, and love thinks no evil. Love rejoices, not iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things, and love never fails. Now you two only to love one another with the love of God, because the love of men is so finite or fragile, but the love of God is indeed infinite. At this time, can I shake the face one another, please?
Thank you. Ballin'!